Uganda's electricity subsector is run on a financially sustaining model where a majority of the financial requirements of sector players is recovered through the end-user tariff paid by the public. As such, the entities in this sector, including UMEME, UEGCL, UETCL and UEDCL, submit annual applications detailing their investment plans. For 2024, the agencies presented a total budget of 1.7 trillion shillings, majority of which shall be utilized by UETCL to purchase energy from generators and investments in infrastructure to meet the increasing demand of electricity in the country.
That is an opportunity to us because we are able to plan with certainty. Only 40% of the population has access to electricity. That is also a challenge, but it's also an opportunity in terms of accelerating demand if our sister utilities distribution undertaking the necessary initiatives to ensure electrification, then it will unlock that unutilized capacity.
UEGCL presented a budget of about 92 billion shillings, majority of which shall be for investing in rehabilitation and replacement of old equipment at the Nalubale and Chira power plants in Jinja, to prevent a repeat of the 2020 incident where water hyphen entered the plant's powerhouse.
Is those places near the power plants, because there are two in parallel. We have Owen Falls, we have Kira. They have to put a barrier. That barrier is what we call the floating boom. If you visit, the only plant that has that structure right now is Vijagadi. If you visit Vijagadi, you'll be able to see something like that. We are going to install a similar one at Karuma and at Isimba as well.
To Ojambo's question, we indicated that we are executing a number of investments and also to reaffirm our obligations to deliver on the license continue until the last day of the concession. I indicated in my presentation that we are executing a number of investments. Our investment plan is around 130 billion, which is around $35 million, where we are rebuilding the Hoima substation, there's Matuga substation, there's West Bank in Jinja, we have Owen Falls upgrade, a number of transformer injections, all those including technology.
The Electricity Regulatory Authority is expected to rely on these applications to determine next year's base tariff before the end of this month. Story by Benon Ojambo for the news.